Since 2001, the federal government has funded over $12 billion for nanotechnology, and that number is going to keep going up, right? And nanotechnology, it's starting to change the way things are in everyday life, right? All different types of applications.
What we try to do here is something rather unique. We try to combine knowledge with education and economic development. See, if you look into a classic research center, they pretty much do research, right? What we are trying to do is more than that. We are trying to grow the next generation of scientists in Arkansas. We try to take the students and turn them into scientists, turn them into highly educated individuals.
I always knew that I wanted to be a scientist. And before coming to the Nano Center, I never knew how that would happen. And they're actually helping me realize that dream. I chose to do research at UALR because I knew that realistically at other universities, doing research for undergraduates, doing research for high school students, the research isn't up to you. And at UALR, I was given that option. I was given the choice to do research and what I wanted.
Others have heard about the center now through some of their high school research projects and are being attracted to it and choosing UALR over other institutions because of the Nanotechnology Center.
I did choose UALR. Like, I was accepted to Washington University in St. Louis, but I decided that there were more opportunities with nanotechnology, so I felt like I'd get farther with this opportunity, especially because I'd already been in the research and it was extremely interesting.
With a consortium that is developing here in Arkansas, we now have the training and educational component, which can feed a pipeline of new technology people who would normally go somewhere else instead of staying in Arkansas. It would enhance the base here in Arkansas.
We are really interested also in working with the industry. We have actually helped some of these companies to come and analyze their products based on the equipment that we have in such a way that their products will become more competitive and hopefully they will ultimately lead to more jobs in Arkansas.
The UALR Center allows us to have that equipment available so that we can bring samples up here, have them analyzed, and get results back very quickly. That allows us to put our new products out on the market much quicker.
Most of your scientists and researchers that are involved in this area, they just keep uncovering new applications, new situations, day by day. And so we teamed up with Alex to work with him to commercialize the intellectual property that's coming out of the Nanotechnology Center.
Besides the people that work with me and I work with on a daily basis, there are a number of other people that have helped us tremendously. They are the real visionaries that have actually made this possible, you know. We are talking about, of course, the governor. We are talking about a number of legislators. We are talking about this university that has an amazing leadership and is really moving into developing itself as a top university very fast.
I'm very proud of the research that I do here, and I'm proud to be a part of the scientific community here at the Nano Center.
Knowledge and technology drives innovation. And if you have these facilities like the Research Park or like the Nanotechnology Center, that is the incubator, if you want, of these ideas and discoveries, that just speaks so well for the future this area has.
We have to work together as a community, as a group of people that really want to do better for the state. So that's what I do on a daily basis. I don't do anything special. Just try to understand and capture towards a product, a technology, that hopefully this grain of salt, this grain of sand, will actually create something really big in the future. That's all.